Have you ever wondered that how this raw tomato, while entering a food factory, gets magically transformed into a tomato ketchup? Well, in this video, I'm going to explain you food science and food technology using the example of tomato and a tomato ketchup, and along with that, the example of a Hot Wheels track. So stay with me till the end of the video because you are going to learn something new today. Hello everyone, I am Arif Irshad and you are watching Food Tech Simplified, where I make easy to understand and simple lectures and tutorials on food science and food technology. So before jumping into today's topic, I would highly recommend you that guys please take a paper and a pen to take some notes, because these notes are going to be helpful for you in the future if you are giving a test or an exam. So let's jump right into today's topic, that what food technology actually is. So guys, I hope that you know that how a wall is built, right? Or how a building, a tall structure is built. You must be knowing the basics. First of all, you lay a strong foundation, a very strong foundation, and then you start laying the bricks one on top of another, right? It's that simple. But for a tall structure to stand tall, the foundation has to be very strong. And in the case of, in the scenario of food science and food technology, the food technology is like a tall building, right? And food science is like a very strong foundation. So foundation has to be very strong in the, if you want to master food technology. So the foundation, food science, first of all, we are going to understand what is food science. See, food science, if I have to explain food science in one line, food science is simply the application of science on a food to study its nature. Now, what does this statement mean? This really means that science is applied. When we say science is applied, that means a number of experimentations are done. Some kind of actions are taken upon a specific food product. In our case, tomato. So, in our case, if we have to study food science, what that will really mean, that will mean that I will conduct some experimentations or I will take some actions on any kind of food product or tomato to study the nature of tomato, of this specific tomato, or all the tomatoes in general. So see, science is a very practical subject. Science is based on experimentations and their conclusions. And when you gather these conclusions, when you note down these conclusions, the study that is done on the conclusions is food science. So food science is just simply the studying of the nature of any kind of food when science is applied on them. That means when an experiment is done on them. So now that you have an idea of food science, let us move on to food technology. So food technology and food science are really very connected terms. They are overlapping terms, and someone can easily misunderstand or misinterpret the meaning of food technology and food science. But let me clarify this down today. See, the food technology part is incomplete without food science. If I have to explain food technology in one line, then food technology is the application of science, of food science to be precise, on the food to produce a processed product that is not just delicious but also safe and healthy to consume. What does this statement mean? Let me back the statement with another example of hammer and nail. If you have to hammer a nail into the wall, you have to know how much force or pressure you are going to put on the nail, right? You have to know how much pressure you are going to put on the nail, and you have to know what kind of nail you are going to use. And while you are hammering the nail, you also have to take care about your fingers, that you don't hurt your fingers, right? You don't want to hurt your fingers. So let me take another example, another interesting example that will make the concept of food science and food technology more clear to you. See, this is a Hot Wheels track, and this is my nephew's track, by the way, so don't tell him. See, I have a car right here. I have a launcher, and I have a simple piece of track, a single piece of track. It's a very simple track. And the working of this track, now you might be thinking that, Arif, wait, what a Hot Wheels track has to do with food science and food technology? See, I don't think there is any connection between food science and food technology at all, but I'm just proving the example. I'm just trying to prove my point that how food technology actually works. I'm just trying to level it down to so that you can understand, so that a beginner who is a beginner in food technology can really understand what food technology and food science is. So in this case, in the case of this track, a car can move very smoothly on the track, right? But to move on the track, it is going to need some kind of energy or some kind of push. So this launcher is going to provide the essential energy for this car to move, right? It works something like this. See, it is that simple. So, but if the track is not there, if the launcher is not there, the car cannot move on its own if it does not get a push. So in the scenario of food science and food technology, this launcher, this yellow colored launcher right here acts like food science. It is actually a food science part. Why? Because food science provides essential knowledge and essential push or essential background for a food technologist to make a processed product like a ketchup. And the track part of this setup is just like food technology. Why? Because the food technology part provides the essential pathway or a process for a product to be processed and developed. See, and whenever a food like this car, let's assume this car is food, whenever this food is tested by food science, the knowledge of food science helps a food technologist like you and me to make this product successful through the knowledge of food science and by using a simple track, just by launching it. So one more interesting fact in this setup is that if you remove food science part from food technology, you're probably not going to make any kind of food because you need the knowledge of food science. If you don't have the knowledge of food science, the car is not going to move. The food is not going to be produced. So you need to have food science joined along with the food technology so that an industry can work, so that a food technologist can work. A food technologist must be having in-depth knowledge of food science. Without the knowledge of food science, it is highly unlikely that he can process or formulate a process that can produce a product like tomato ketchup or any kind of processed product. So food technology is the application of food science on the food to formulate a process so that a product can be produced. You can also say that food technology is the practical aspect of food science. So this was about food technology and food science. I hope you get the distinction. I hope you got my point that how this tomato can be converted using food technology in a processed product like a ketchup. So one more thing that I would like to mention, that how food technology actually works in a food factory, we may get into that deeper in later videos, but how a tomato actually gets converted into a tomato ketchup. See, there are a lot of operations which are going on in a food factory. In a food factory, whenever a raw agricultural tomato enters, what happens, the washing happens, right? The tomatoes are graded, the tomatoes are sorted, and they may be blanched, or the pulp is taken, or pulping is done, and then addition of ingredients. And there are a lot of operations like packaging and distribution, storage, cooling, and all that stuff. I'm not going to get deeper in that. I will get deeper in that in later videos. So what happens in a food factory is that this specific tomato, or all the tomatoes in general, undergo some transformation based on some operations. And these operations are formulated by food technologists based on the knowledge of food science. And whenever this enters into a food factory, it's always going to be converted into something of like a processed product, like a tomato ketchup. And the duty of the food technologist is not just making a product. His duty or her duty is to make a product that is not just delicious, but also nutrition and wholesome and safe to consume. Right, so I hope you understood what food technology and food science means. And so this was it for today, and I hope that you understood the meaning. And before I go, I would like to leave you with a thought. I recommend you that the language that I've used, the definition I have used today for explaining food science and food technology, if you write the same exact words in a test on an exam, it is highly unlikely that your faculty or your professor is going to give you awesome grades, because it is missing the essential scientific keywords. And see, I totally respect the grades and GPA, all that stuff, but I believe that understanding is even much more important than the part of the grades. So enough with the torture, enough with the counseling. I'm going to leave you guys right now, and if you like the video, thumbs up. If you dislike the video, let me know specifically that why you hate this video. And in the comment section, let me know if you found the hot wheels example valuable. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, what are you waiting for? Judgment day, subscribe to the channel. Thank you, class dismissed.